Morning, gang. Happy Monday. So it's one of these days I don't have to look pretty for you guys. As we go into, by popular demand, another episode of Cooking with Mrs. Pinball. And today she's going to be making her stroganoff. And as I said to everybody many times, you know, we try to do things that you can do with your preps. But the only thing here that you're not going to get, I mean, you know, dried sour cream, we've probably all got that in our preps, whatever it would be. If you have to, can of fully cooked roast beef, work fine for this. Obviously, we're going to do it with fresh meat because at this point in life, we can. But without further ado, here's Mrs. Pinball.
Hi, everybody. This is Mrs. Pinball, and tonight we're making stroganoff. Here is what we need. Vegetable oil. Flour, we will need about 3 tablespoons. Mushrooms, beef, 1 onion. Butter, we will need probably 2 tablespoons of butter. 8 ounces of sour cream, salt and pepper. First of all, we are cutting our meat across this the fibers into strips. Quarter of an inch to a half of inch long. There is a legend that old Count Stroganov couldn't chew because of he didn't have his teeth anymore. So his French cook invented this meal for him. This is how big our pieces came out. And now it's time to add flour. Don't be afraid to put too much flour because extra flour we will shake off in colander. The recipe which I'm giving you is the easiest one, in my opinion. Though it's still classical. So let's All right, we are shaking off our flour excess. Doesn't look like there is any excess. The best meat for stroganoff is tenderloin. But if you don't have tenderloin, it's still going to be tender and delicious. Next thing is to cut onion. I'm going to cut it in a small cubes. Like that. Next step is to cut mushrooms. Here we have 8 ounces of mushrooms. But if you bought already sliced mushrooms, then you don't even have to cut them. That's how I'm going to cut. The next step is to warm up the pan and add oil. Put generous amount of oil, and we need both pan and oil hot, and you will see that it's ready when you will see smoke. Now our pan and oil are hot enough, so we can add onion. And we can fry it super fast and evaporate all the moisture out of it. You can turn it off. All right, our onion is ready and now it's time to add beef. It's important to add beef in one layer. We will fry it for 3, maybe 4 minutes maximum. So don't be afraid to put your stove on a maximum heat. After 1 minute, we are turning our meat around. All right, meat is ready. We are turning off the flame. And the fact that we fried it on maximum temperature and we add flour, let all the juices stay in. Flour and heat kinda sealed all the juices. On the same burner, which is still hot, I put my pot and put all the meat in it. I save some juices in the pan. I'll need it for later. Now it's time to fry mushrooms. We are frying it on small amount of vegetable oil and we will fry it till all the moisture evaporates. The liquid evaporated, mushrooms are ready, and we are putting them to our beef. Now, in the same pan which we cooked our beef in, we put 2 tablespoons of butter and melt it. When butter is melted, it's time to add sour cream. And we are going to stir it constantly. Salt it and pepper it on your taste. Stir it again. And now we are adding our sauce to beef and mushrooms. Stir it for a couple more minutes. Turn it off. And in 2 minutes we are turning off the flame. Our stroganoff is ready.
And there you have it, guys. There is a plate of stroganoff over a bed of rice. Traditionally it's over mashed potatoes, but we eat it over rice or egg noodles or anything else of the sort like that. But that's traditional Russian stroganoff there. And now it's my turn to sit down and have dinner. Have a good one, y'all. Pinball out.